Recorded Books Incorporated presents an unabridged recording of April's Kittens by Clare Turlay Newberry, narrated by Barbara Caruso.
There once was a nice little girl named April, who lived in New York City with her mother, her father, and a black cat named Sheba. Nobody has much room in New York because so many people are trying to live there at the same time. So April and her mother and father and Sheba lived all crowded up together in a very small apartment. It was so small that there wasn't even room in it for April to have a real bed. And although she was six, she still slept in a crib. April's father called it a one-cat apartment, and he often warned Sheba against having a family. "One cat is all very well," he would say, smoothing her sleek black head, "but one is quite enough. Remember that, Sheba. This is a strictly one-cat apartment." Sheba, however, paid not the slightest attention. She went right ahead and had kittens, three of them, one black and two with tiger stripes. Of course, April was enchanted. All day long, she sat on the floor beside Sheba's box and adored them. It was all her mother could do to pry her away from them long enough to brush her hair, or wash her face, or eat her meals. All she wanted to do was sit on the floor and watch Sheba's kittens. Her father was not nearly so pleased with them. "Four cats in an apartment this size is exactly three too many," he grumbled. "You will have to do something about those kittens, Margaret. And the sooner the better, before April gets attached to them." "Now, Charles, those kittens can't possibly bother you while they're so tiny. They don't make any noise, and they're too little to climb out of the box. Don't worry. We'll find homes for them all in good time." April did not listen. She was much too busy watching the kittens. One of the striped ones had a white nose and forehead, which made her look as though her hair were parted in the middle. Her little paws were white, too, and the tiny pads on them were of the tenderest pink. April ran a gentle forefinger over her little furry head and gave a sigh of pure happiness. Then she stroked the other two and Sheba, so they wouldn't feel neglected. It was plain to her that Daddy was mistaken about there being room in the apartment for only one cat. Here they were with four, and how much more delightful life was for everyone. So April thought. "What are we going to name them, Mommy?" she asked one day. "Well, let's see now," said her mother, glancing up from the dress she was lengthening for April. "How about Tommy? Or Tiger? Or Tabby?" April considered, frowning seriously. Then she shook her head. "No, Mommy, I don't like any of those."
"Well, then, how about Midge? Or Mouser? Or how about Midnight for the little black one?"
"No, Mommy, I don't like any of those either," said April to each suggestion, and she begged her mother to think of some more names. This went on for days. At last, her father took a hand.
"I'm going to name those kittens myself, here and now, and get it settled," he announced one morning, and he strode across the room to the kitten box. The kittens already had their eyes open and were busily crawling over, under, and around Sheba and each other. It was certainly high time they had names.
Said April's father, regarding them thoughtfully. He tickled the black one's fat little tummy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.